is now being recorded.
Okay, good morning all of you.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning, good morning. Today, in this presentation, we will discuss how to determine wave length using diffraction grating. Something is disturbing. Who is that? Mute it, go, Namma. Okay, right. We know we have different methods to determine wavelength of light. Initially, in the interference pattern, there is number of instruments we have. The first one is light single mirror experiment. Using that, we determine wavelength of light. Thereafter, Newton-Rings experiment. Of course, using that also, we can determine wavelength of light. Thereafter, Michelson interferometer. Using that instrument also, we determine wavelength of light. So this is also one of the instrument that is diffraction grating. Using these, we can determine wavelength of light. So what is diffraction grating? Already we discussed yesterday. So we know diffraction grating is nothing but it is an arrangement and it consisting large number of parallel slits having same width and separated by equal opaque spaces. It is separated by equal opaque spaces. Already I told you this is the diffraction grating. So in this diffraction grating, whose length is 1 inch, that is a 2.54 centimeter, according to this, in the per inch there is 15,000 slits are there. There is 15,000 slits are there. So this is about, this is called the grating. Of course, there are number of gratings we have. This is a transmission grating, and reflection grating is also there, but we are using only transmission gratings in our laboratory. You see here in this diagram, there is a W dash is the plane wave front. AB is the diffraction. Actually, AB is the diffraction grating. It consisting capital N number of slits. L is a convex lens because this is Fraunhofer diffraction to observe the fringe pattern. Convex lens is compulsory in Fraunhofer diffraction because already we discussed the differences between Fraunhofer diffraction and Fresnel diffraction. In a Fresnel diffraction, there is no lenses are required. In Fresnel diffraction, there is no lenses are required. But in Fraunhofer diffraction, to get the parallel beam, convex lens is required in the laboratory. And of course, to observe the fringe pattern also, convex lens is required. So this is the screen where we have to observe the intensity position. That may be principal maxima or may be secondary maxima and minimum intensity positions. So you see here, that is the light ray that is from the plane, that is a plane wavefront. The rays are which is incident on the diffraction grating AB. Actually, Huygens principle, according to the Huygens principle, every point on this grating AB will act as a source to the secondary wavelets. Am I right? Because we discussed that number of times. Every point on the wavefront act as a source to the secondary wavelets. Then what happens? This AB, that is a diffraction grating plane, will act as a source to the secondary wavelets. So from that place, these rays will go in all directions. From this AB plane, the rays will scatter or will diffracted in all directions. Some of the rays may be directly incident on the lens L and are supposed to be concentrated P0. So when the light rays is traveling along the direction of the incident ray, just like that, all these rays will be concentrated at point P0. Of course, we know that is the principal maxima where the intensity is very, very high. And what about some of the rays, you know, you see here, that is angle theta. Some of the rays which makes angle theta with the incident direction will be supposed to concentrated at another point P1 on the screen. You see here, at the another point on the screen, P1. Where the point P1 may be bright or dark. depending on the path reference or phase reference. Depending on the path reference and phase reference. Already we discussed about this phase difference and a path difference and the condition for the principal maxima we discussed yesterday. So by using this gradient diffraction grating, how can we calculate this wavelength of lambda? We will discuss now. To determine this wavelength of light, we may use diffraction grating in the laboratory. Of course, in a diffraction grating, the principal maxima are obtained the direction given by. It means that what is the condition for the principal maxima by using the diffraction grating? Yeah, what I told yesterday, that is E plus D into sin theta is equal to n lambda. This very, very important formula. You also must remember this. Because E plus D into sin theta lambda is equal to n lambda is the condition for the principal maxima. By using this principle, we can determine the wavelength lambda, that is the lambda. Where what is individually, we know E plus D, that is called grating element, already I told you yesterday. E is the slit width. E is the slit width. D is the spacing between two slits. D is the spacing between two slits. Then E plus D is called grating element. Sin theta. Theta is the angle of diffraction. N is the, that is order of the spectrum. N is the order of the spectrum. Why I am saying this order of the spectrum? Because in diffraction grating, there is a number of principal maxima. There is number of principal maxima because in this case n contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So there is number of principal maxima we have. It is nothing but number of maxima, secondary maxima we have, secondary number of minima we have. So this is depending on the principal maxima, that is gives the order. Actually in our laboratory, we will take readings in the first order only, that is nothing but n is equal to 1. We know lambda is the wavelength of light what we use in the laboratory. So our aim is to calculate wavelength lambda. So that from that, lambda is equal to how much? E plus D into sin theta by small n. When E plus D we know, theta is angle of diffraction we know, then easily we can determine the wavelength lambda. So E plus D, how can we calculate? E plus D, how can we calculate? Of course, that is depending on the manufacturer. The value of the E plus D is depending on the manufacturer. So you see here, E plus D is called the grating element. N is the order of the spectrum. And the theta is the angle of diffraction corresponding to a particular wavelength. Because if you use in the source of light as a single wavelength, that is monochromatic light, there is no problem. There is only single spectrum. There is only single line. If when we use white light, then what happens? When we observe from the grating, there is a seven color, that is vibgier we may see. There is vibgier, that is seven colors we may observe through the diffraction grating when white light is used. So for all the rays, that is for all the seven colors, we can determine the wavelength of lambda by using this diffraction grating, by using the single experiment. కదా ఒక ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ ఉపయోగించి డైఫ్రాక్షన్ గ్రేటింగ్ తో వైట్ లైట్ ఉపయోగిస్తే ఆ ఏడు రంగుల యొక్క వివరణ మనం కనుక్కోవచ్చు. ఓకే, నౌ యూ సీ హియర్ దేర్ ఇస్ అ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ లైన్స్ ఎన్ రూల్ అండ్ ది గ్రేటింగ్ ఓవర్ ఇట్ బై ఓవర్ ది మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చర్. సో ఎన్ ఈస్ డిపెండింగ్ ఆన్ ద మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చర్. ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ ఇన్ అవర్ లెబొరేటరీ దేర్ ఇస్ అ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ గ్రేటింగ్, ఇట్ కంటైన్స్ 15,000. యు సీ హియర్ దట్ ఇస్ 15,000 LPI. There is nothing but 15,000 lines per inch. That is for 1 inch, there is 15,000 slits are there. From that, we can easily determine E plus D. So that there is N into E plus D is equal to 1 inch, that is equal to 2.54 centimeter. You know, 1 is equal to 1 inch is equal to 2.5 centimeter. N is number of slits on this diffraction grating. And E plus is the grating element. Then E plus D is equal to 1 inch, that is equal to 2.54 centimeter. From that, E plus D is equal to 2.54 by n centimeter. Of course, that is easily calculated because the n value we already fixed in our gradient. That is 15,000. So if this d is equal to 2.545 15,000 by using that, we can determine this diffraction grating element. So if this d will, so n is we know because we are seeing order of the spectrum is 1. And when we know the angle of diffraction theta, when we know the angle of diffraction theta, and we substitute into this equation, we can determine wavelength of lambda. Now we will see here, now how can we calculate this? This here, how can we calculate this theta? You see, we see, you observe here, you see. To determine the wavelength of light involving the measurement of angle of diffraction theta for a given wavelength of light for a particular order n, of course in this case that is n is we are taking only one because in the first order spectrum. Of course by using this spectrum, how can we observe? The spectrum can be observed using diffraction grating by utilizing this spectrometer. This spectrometer, we know in our laboratory also, I think 4 or 5 spectrometers we have in our laboratory. By using this spectrometer, so we can determine, we can observe this spectrum. And by using this spectrum, we can determine the angle of diffraction theta. Okay, angle of diffraction theta, and we can calculate the wavelength of light for the given color. So before using this instrument, that is a spectrometer, we want to make some adjustments. What are they? The first one is the spectrometer is adjusted for parallel rays by Schutzhard method. The spectrometer is adjusted for parallel rays because we are here seeing Fraunhofer diffraction. So Fraunhofer diffraction is nothing but the source is at infinite distance. Source is at infinite distance is nothing but the rays are parallel. So that how can make this in laboratory? Because the infinite distance we cannot make the source. Of course, one of the example is the sun that is at infinite distance. But the sun rays cannot go into our laboratory to do this experiment. We are using instant light source, maybe mercury vapor lamp or sodium vapor lamp. At our finite distance. If it is at finite distance, that diffraction is called Fresnel diffraction. That is not Fraunhofer diffraction. But in this case, we are using Fraunhofer diffraction is nothing but that rays must be parallel. How can we make it? But to make this parallel rays, we will use collimator. So by using this collimator, there is a lens that is convex lens. By adjusting this collimator, with the rays make as parallel rays. That is by using the collimated lens. And what about second adjustment? The grating is adjusted for normal incidence. Because why? We know the cushion is the same as that one. To determine the wavelength of light using normal incidence, what we told. So that when the grating is made perpendicular to the light rays, that is called normal incidence. How can we adjust this normal incidence? We will observe here. Of course, the same experiment we have in our laboratory. We will do that experiment also. Yeah, how can we? Of course, initially, the slit is illuminated by a given source of light. Illuminated is nothing but by projecting. The light source is sent out. Given source of light, it may be white light or maybe sodium vapor lamp. Actually, in most of our laboratories, in all the degree level physics laboratories, we have first a mercury vapor lamp that gives white light, and maybe sodium vapor lamp that gives yellow color. In most of the cases, we will do this white color on all the experiments. And of course, in one of the experiments, that is in the Newton-Lynx experiment, we will use monochromatic light, that is sodium vapor lamp. because when we use sodium vapor lamp in the interferometer, that is of course Newton rings experiment, the rings are very bright. So the position of this telescope is adjusted, periscope here is adjusted in such a way that the image of the slit is focused on the vertical crosswire in the field of your telescope. So there is in this spectrometer, you know, at intermediate level also, the theory we have behind this spectrometer, there is actually three parts. One is collimator to make the light rays are parallel. Second one is a prism table to make the prism, to keep the prism on that. Of course, that is also make a grating on that. That is called a prism table. And third one is called a telescope to observe all the spectrum. That is called a spectrometer. Of course, we will do the experiment with this one. Next. In this position, the collimator and telescope are in a straight line. This position, the collimator and the telescope are in a straight line because the collimator is actually fixed in the spectrometer, but the telescope can rotate in any direction. The collimator, that is telescope, can rotate in any direction. So initially, those two, because that vertical crosswise in the telescope is focused on the white light, is focused on the light source. So that the slit of this collimator. So that in this case, the collimator and the telescope are in a straight line. Now the position of the telescope is noted on the circular scale. Actually, there is a spectrometer containing two circular scales, one circular scale and two vernier scales. That is taken as V1 and V2. Already we done in the previous week, that is one of the experiment by using the spectrometer. Yeah, there is two scales we have, two vernier scales. So by using this vernier scales or maybe circular scales, we want to take the reading, that is a straight line reading. Em chestamo collimator telescope rendu straight ga unnapudu andulo unnatundi circular scale yokka reading teeskovalanamata edo oka vernier scale edo V1 medaina teeskovachu V2 medaina teeskovachu. Because this is a normal incidence, so that it turns 90 degrees and clamp. Em cheyali first, akkada unnatu telescope no oka 90 degrees varuku tippi akkada manam beginchal, that is clamp. You see here that experiment procedure how it is. You see that is the source of light, yes. Source of light, yes, it may be monochromatic light or maybe white light. So this is the collimator. This is the collimator. What do you have? There is a collimator contain one slit and one lens. That lens is used to make the light rays is parallel. This end, this edges, we have lens that makes parallel rays. At this left hand, there is a slit in the collimator. And this is the grating which is placed on the prism table. This is the grating which is placed on the prism table, and actually that is the field of view of the eyepiece. So that is the eyepiece, the telescope eyepiece. Of course, this is telescope. You see, initially this collimator and this eyepiece is in a straight line. By using this eyepiece, there is a crosswire in this eyepiece. This crosswire is coincided with the slit on the collimator. Em cheyalo mana eyepiece lo ikka nunchi chustu ikkada collimator lo ee chevaru untundannamata slit ikkada unnatondi crosswire ni ee slit tho coincided chesi teesukuntam first reading. When this, in this case, the collimator and eyepiece are in a straight line, so initially there is a source S from this light ray, it came outside like this. You see here, this is the source of light. The light ray will come through this source, and by using this collimator slit, that is, it makes as fine line, and by using this lens, collimating lens, these rays are parallel. Then what happens? This light ray is incident on this diffraction grating. ఎలైటేముని ఎస్ నుంచి వచ్చి ఇక్కడ ఉన్నటువంటి స్లిట్ ద్వారా ఇక్కడ ఉన్న లెన్స్ ద్వారా ప్యారలల్ బీమ్ వచ్చి అక్కడ ఉన్నటువంటి గ్రేటింగ్ మీద పడుతుంది అన్నమాట. దెన్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్, ద గ్రేటింగ్ విల్ స్ప్లిట్ దిస్ లైట్ ఇన్ టు 7 కలర్స్. ఇఫ్ దిస్ లైట్ ఈస్ వైట్ కలర్, ఇఫ్ ద లైట్ ఈస్ వైట్ కలర్, ద లైట్ విల్ ఎమిట్ 6-7 కలర్స్, దట్ ఈస్ యూ సీ లైక్ దిస్. యూ సీ వన్స్ అగైన్, సో దిస్ ఈస్ లైట్ రేస్ విల్ కమ్ లైక్ దిస్. We know in all the spectrum contains 7 colors, that is Bipjia. You see here, that is V1 and R1, what shows? V1 and this is a violet color, R1 is a red color spectrum. In between this V1 and R1, remaining 7 colors, 5 colors we have. So one, what I am saying is, that is called first spectrum, first order spectrum. For this case, that is N is equal to 1. For this case, N is equal to 1. And if it is V2 and R2, this is violet color of the second order spectrum, R2 is the red color of the second order spectrum. So manam chuste indulonchi ee IPC ela jarukuntu velipayam ankonde ee area lo 7 colors kanipisthayi, inka koncham mundu jaripayam ankonde malli ikkada kuda 7 colors kanipisthayi, inka mundu velipayam ankonde ikkada kuda inka second 7 colors kanipisthayi, that is the third order spectrum. Not only to the right side, even left side also you see here V1, R1, there is one spectrum, that is first order spectrum. This is V2, R2, this is second order spectrum. So from this straight line propagation, there is both sides, that is right side and maybe left side, there is number of fringes or number of spectrum we will observe. So initially the eyepiece is directly coincided with this slit and first reading we will take. Thereafter this eyepiece will move towards the one of the ray, that is red one color, where we have to take reading. Now the angle between this straight line, this reading at R1, which gives the angle of scattering theta. For accuracy we will take this eyepiece into this R1 also, like this you see here. At this position also we will take one more reading. So the angle between this R1 and this R1 is equal to 2 theta. From that we can determine the angle of diffraction theta. If this theta is substituted into this first equation, that is lambda is equal to e plus d into sin theta by n, we can determine the wavelength lambda. Of course we will discuss one by one later now. So the given grating is mounted at the center of the prism table. Here actually this is the prism table. This grating is mounted bigista on the pina. మనకు ఒక స్టాండ్ ఉంటుంది ఇక్కడ ప్రిజమ్ టేబుల్ మీద, ఆ స్టాండ్ పెట్టేసి మనం నిలబెడతాం. అఫ్ కోర్స్ దిస్ ఇస్ పెర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ది నార్మల్ లైట్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్. ద ప్రిజమ్ టేబుల్ ఈస్ నౌ రొటేటెడ్ సో దట్ ది ఇమేజ్ ఆఫ్ ద స్లిట్ రిఫ్లెక్టెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద గ్రేటింగ్ జస్ట్ యూ సీ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ ఇన్ దిస్ అఫ్ కోర్స్ ఇది ఏమిటి మనం దట్ ఇనిషియల్లీ దిస్ టెలిస్కోప్ ఈస్ కాన్సన్ట్రేటెడ్ 90 degrees అంటే ఈ పొజిషన్లో ఉంచాలి. ఫస్ట్ ఏం చేస్తాం అనుకున్నాము, స్ట్రైట్ లైన్లో ఇక్కడ ఉన్నప్పుడు ఫస్ట్ ఇక్కడ ఉన్నప్పుడు డైరెక్ట్ రీడింగ్ తీసుకుంటాం కదా టెలిస్కోప్కి. నార్మల్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్ కావాలని చేయాలి ఈ పై ఈ ఐపీస్ ఏదైతే ఉందో ఐపీస్ను ఇక్కడ నుంచి రొటేట్ చేస్తూ ఇక్కడికి తీసుకురావాలి. దాని వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్, ఇఫ్ ద ఐపీస్ ఈజ్ అట్ దిస్ ప్లేస్ ద యాంగిల్ బిట్వీన్ దిస్ 90 degrees, సో దట్ వ్యాన్సింగ్ నవ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ టర్న్ టు 90 degrees, అంటే ఇక్కడ ఈ ప్లేస్ లో అనమాట అండ్ క్లాంప్ అక్కడ బిగించాలి అనుకున్నాము. నౌ వాట్ వి హావ్, నౌ ద గివెన్ గ్రేటింగ్ ఇస్ మౌంటెడ్ ద సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రిజమ్ టేబుల్ అండ్ నౌ గ్రేటింగ్ సర్ఫేస్ ఇస్ పెర్పెండ్ విత్ ద ప్రిజమ్ టేబుల్. ద ప్రిజమ్ టేబుల్ ఇస్ నౌ రొటేటెడ్ సో దట్ ద ఇమేజ్ ఆఫ్ ద స్లిట్ రిఫ్లెక్టెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద గ్రేటింగ్ సర్ఫేస్ లైట్ అట్ ది ఇంటర్సెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ద క్రాస్ వైర్. నౌ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్, దిస్ ప్రిజమ్ టేబుల్ విల్ రొటేట్. Then what happens if this prism, this grating will make 45 degrees, will make 45 degrees, the light ray reflected at this place and goes along this direction and it is incident on this telescope at this place. Telescope ekkada nunchi ikkada varaku teeskochaam kada, ee light is reflect ayi ikkada velli padutundi anamata. At this place this grating is along this direction, it makes 45 degrees. Now again, in this position, the grating is 45 degrees to the incident light. Now the prism table is suitably rotated again to the 45 degrees. So already it is at 45 degrees. Now again we are rotating 45 degrees. Then what happens? 45 plus 45, that is 90 degrees. That is the grating is exactly normal to the incident line. ఇప్పుడు ఇప్పుడు ఎలా ఉందో నార్మల్ గా చక్కగా కరెక్ట్ గా నార్మల్ గా వచ్చేసింది అంటే 90 డిగ్రీస్ కి వచ్చేస్తున్నాం అనుకోండి 182 లేకుండా. సో దట్ వి ఆర్ డిస్కసింగ్ ఇన్ ది నార్మల్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్. మన ఈ క్వశ్చన్ లో చదివేది నార్మల్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్ కాబట్టి ఎలా మనం 90 నార్మల్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్ ని అప్రోచ్ చేసుకోవాలి. ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ నార్మల్ ఇన్సిడెన్స్. వెన్ ద సోర్స్ ఆఫ్ లైట్ ఎమిటెడ్ రేడియేషన్ ఆఫ్ డిఫరెంట్ వేవ్ లెంగ్త్స్ because it may be multiple color, that may be white source, then the beam gets dispersed by the grating. You see the light ray which is incident on the grating is dispersed into different colors, and each order of the spectrum of the constituent wavelength is observed. This is the spectrum, this is another spectrum, this is another spectrum, this is another spectrum. We can observe all these spectrums by using this telescope. This is first order spectrum, this is also first order spectrum, because just the first of the middle point avagane motta motta pani kanipinche spectrum kabatti first order annaru. Deeni yokka spectrum tarvata rendovadi kanipistundi kabatti that is called second order spectrum, that is taken as n is equal to 2. Now the telescope is now turning to get the first order spectrum, that is just like that. The crosswire is adjusted on the line for which the wavelength is to be determined. ఎక్కడైతే మనం వేలంగు యొక్క వేవ్ లెంగ్త్ కనుక్కోవాలనుకుంటున్నాము అక్కడ ఉన్నటువంటి ఐపీస్ అక్కడికి అడ్జస్ట్ చేయాలన్నమాట. ద పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ద టెలిస్కోప్ ఈజ్ షోన్ బై డాటెడ్ లైన్స్ ఇన్ ది ఫిగర్. ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ ద రీడింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద టూ వెర్నియర్ స్కేల్స్ ఆర్ నోటెడ్. యు సీ దట్ ఈజ్ సోర్స్ ఆల్రెడీ టోల్డ్ యూ దిస్ ఈజ్ క్యారిమీటర్, దట్ ఈజ్ గ్రేటింగ్, దట్ ఈజ్ ప్లేన్ ఆఫ్ eyepiece, that is eyepiece telescope. This is a light ray, this is incident on the grating and the deviated into different spectrum. Now what will we do? This is throw core wire, crosswire is adjusted to one of the line for which the wavelength is to be determined. For example, manu red color yoka wavelength kankovali anukuntam anukondi. Our aim is to calibrate the wavelength of the red color. Then what happens? This telescope is moved to the R1 place, just like that. Here, from this place, the eyepiece or telescope is moving towards this side. Then what happens? This red line we may observe by using this telescope. By using this telescope, now we have to take this reading. That is vernier scale V1 and V2. అటు ఇటు రెండు వినియర్ స్కేల్స్ ఉంటాయి అనుకుంటాం కదా, ఆ రీడింగ్ తీసుకోవాలి. దట్ ఈస్ ద రీడింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద టూ వినియర్ స్కేల్స్ ఆర్ నోటెడ్. నౌ ద టెలిస్కోప్ ఇస్ దెన్ టర్న్ టు గో టు ది ఫస్ట్ ఆర్డర్ ఆన్ ది అదర్ సైడ్. వాట్ ఈస్ అదర్ సైడ్? దిస్ ఈస్ అదర్ సైడ్, దట్ ఈస్ లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్. సో అగైన్ దిస్ టెలిస్కోప్ ఈస్ మూవింగ్ టువర్డ్ ద రెడ్ కలర్ ఆఫ్ ది లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్. యు సీ హియర్ లైక్ దిస్. అగైన్ వి వాంట్ టు టేక్ రీడింగ్ దిస్ ఎట్ దిస్. So the telescope is then turned to the go to the first order on the other side, and the crosswire is just on the same color line. Of course, the position of the telescope is shown by the dotted lines here. The reading of the two vernier scales again noted. ఇక్కడ రీడింగ్ తీసుకుంటాము, ఇక్కడ రీడింగ్ తీసుకుంటాము. Of course, the difference between those two readings may be any one of the vernier scale. అక్కడ V1 V2 రెండు ఉన్నాయి కాబట్టి అయితే రెండు వెనియర్ 1లోనే తీసుకోవాలి లేక రెండు వెనియర్ 2లోనే తీసుకోవాలి. ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ దోస్ టూ రీడింగ్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 2 టైమ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్. సో యూ సీ ద డైఫ్రాక్షన్, ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ రీడింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద సేమ్ వెనియర్ స్కేల్స్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ట్వైస్ ద యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ ఫర్ దట్ కలర్. మనం రెడ్ కలర్ అనుకున్నాం కాబట్టి రెడ్ కలర్ యొక్క యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ కి ట్వైస్, దట్ ఈస్ 2 తీటాను సూచిస్తున్నారు. బై సబ్స్టిట్యూటింగ్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ ఇన్ దిస్ బిలో ఈక్వేషన్, వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ ఈక్వేషన్? దట్ ఈస్ ఈ ప్లస్ డి ఇంటూ సైన్ థీటా ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ ఎన్ లాంబ్డా, ఆర్ మేబీ లాంబ్డా ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఈ ప్లస్ డి ఇంటూ సైన్ థీటా బై లాంబ్డా. we can determine the wavelength, that is wavelength of the required light. Maybe red color. మన రెడ్ కలర్ అంటే రెడ్ ఇక్కడ వైలెట్ కలర్ యొక్క వేవ్లెంత్ కనుక్కోవాలి అనుకుంటున్నాం అనుకోండి, వైలెట్ కలర్ మీద క్రాస్ పెడతాం. వైలెట్ కలర్ కాకుండా ఇంకా గ్రీన్ కలర్ యొక్క వేవ్లెంత్ కనుక్కోవాలనుకోండి, ఆ టెలిస్కోప్ ని గ్రీన్ కలర్ దగ్గరే తీసుకెళ్ళాలి. బ్లూ కలర్ యొక్క వేవ్లెంత్ కనుక్కోవాలనుకోండి, అదే టెలిస్కోప్ ని బ్లూ కలర్ దగ్గరే తీసుకెళ్తాం. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద మెథడ్ టు డిటర్మైన్ ది వేవ్లెంత్ ఆఫ్ లైట్ యూజింగ్ దిస్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ గ్రేటింగ్. యా ఓకే, ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ వి హావ్ ఫ్రైడే ల్యూబరేటరీ. Once again, we will observe this. How can we determine wavelength of light using diffraction grating through virtual lab? మనకి ఎలాగు ల్యాబొరేటరీ ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి ఆ రోజు ఫ్రైడే మనకి ల్యాబ్ కార్ట్ పైన 3 అవర్స్, ఇక్కడ మన ల్యాబొరేటరీలోనే మనం ఎలా ఈ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ మనం చేయొచ్చు, ఎలా వేవ్లెంత్ మనం కనుక్కోవచ్చు అన్నది మనం చూపిద్దాం. ఓకే, సో దట్ ఈస్ ద టుడేస్ క్లాస్ అబౌట్ ది టు డిటర్మైన్ wavelength of light. Okay, thank you. Ever any doubts? Any doubts?